Again, Father's Day, and it's about 9:34 right now, a.m. The video shut off while I was recording this. Burgundy okra right here. And this was a green. I thought I planted some spineless okra, which I didn't come up. But this plant here was a zucchini, yellow zucchini. We got several zucchinis off of here. But it looked like, see, I need to get some baking soda and water because that'll help with this type of, it looks like fungus, white on here, white, and just spray on here. Now would be a good time before the sun gets on this, which will be out here in about another half hour, so I got to get this stuff sprayed really good. Well, see, I don't know if I can do it now. It might be too late. See, I look at that leaf right there. I'm not zooming in too much because this camera was shut off again on me. It looks like it's dried out. It looks like it might be, one might be broken in there from getting a zucchini. But you see how big these things are? Step back out of the garden. They're big. That's about 8 feet across. But see how this one is smashed down? Like, I don't understand what happened here. Look at that one right in front of it. Same exact zucchini. And then the three green. Okay, again, anything that starts to die off, I really, really, seriously, you have to question about the stuff they're spraying in the skies, folks. There's no reason for this stuff to be dying off. This has all got fertilizer in here, mixed in here really well earlier in the year. We put 15, 15, 15 fertilizer. We tilled this up. We tilled all this up. The plastic wasn't even on here. Tilled it up and tilled 15, 15, 15 fertilizer on it all. And then the same with the back. This is the number three garden. East to west is about 60 feet. North to south about 32 feet, 34 feet, somewhere in there. But watermelons over here. Cantaloupes and then cucumbers. And then more melon, like honeydews or cantaloupes over here. And this is that giant sunflower that's coming up here. I don't know if that's a... Titan or mammoth or what now, to be honest with you. I've mixed up my seeds so much. But it's one of the bigger ones. So this is in between the south end over there and the north end over there. This is hard to get in here and mow this because this ground is so uneven. So my minis are even worse. These are tomatoes out here now. Huh. Why would I put eggshell down there if there's no tomato? We planted a sucker. You know what suckers are on a tomato plant. I told my wife, I said, I thought those were supposed to grow. So we planted one here. And I went ahead and put eggshells around there. I didn't put it around this one here. This one looks like it didn't die off. But I don't know. We'll see what happens. That is a tomato plant there. It's difficult breathing out here. You can see the small tomatoes down. See that one right there? I don't know if I can see it on the right down there. One up there. This one's got like a little spot on it. Again, not being a horticulturist, I don't know what might be causing that. Leaves look curled as if they were either getting too much water or not enough. And I know it's rained real heavily about three days ago. But the heat has been really brutal. And the plastic adds about 10 degrees or better. And when it's in the 90s, it feels like 103 out here. That's what makes me question about not getting them more water. Although, no, there should be enough water on them. Let's see. I thought that was... Look at how condensed these are, how tightly. I mean, there's no string on this one. I cut it off because I didn't want it to be too strangulated.